Heading into the primary, voters are prioritizing several key issues.
Yeah, News 8's McKenna Alexander breaks down the most recent Franklin and Marshall poll and what it found to be top of mind for voters when casting their ballots.
According to the most recent poll from Franklin and Marshall College, which surveyed 870 registered Pennsylvanian voters, people are most concerned about several issues, including inflation, abortion, immigration, crime, healthcare, and the environment. The poll, which included 390 Democrats, 356 Republicans, and 124 Independents, finds that in a one-on-one matchup, President Joe Biden leads former President Trump by 10 points, 48% to 38%. However, when a third-party candidate is presented as an option, that lead narrows, sitting at 42% to 40%. 40% of voters say both President Biden and Trump are, quote, too old to serve another term.
So what you have are two candidates who are not really well-liked. Something like one in five voters have an unfavorable opinion of both candidates. And that's, you know, we're going to have a close race. And it's going to be really hard, I think, to predict the outcome until the very end, simply because what are those 20% of voters who are going to decide this election? What are they going to do? They're likely not sure. Many of them won't be sure until they, you know, the last week, probably.
When compared to Trump, more voters in Pennsylvania believe Biden has better judgment, is more trustworthy, and is closer to their views on values. In contrast, more voters believe Trump is better equipped to manage the economy.
And the thing that really makes them most concerned about the economy is all the inflation they've seen. So when we ask them, why do you feel like you're worse off than you were a year ago? They say, well, it's because everything's more expensive. The cost of goods and services, the cost of food, the cost of housing have all gone up, and that hurts me.
When it comes to the state Senate race, 39% of voters believe Bob Casey is doing a satisfactory job. When matched up against Republican David McCormick, Casey leads 46% to 39%, which is about the same advantage he held in February and October polls.
Bob Casey, a well-known long-term incumbent against a candidate who's run before but really isn't widely known, I think we'll see in the next few months that changes a lot. But that's where that race is right now.
McKenna Alexander, WGAL News 8.
And if you want to see the full poll, you can find it online at WGAL.com and also on the WGAL app.
If you're planning to vote in person for the primary election, there are some things you should know, especially if it's your first time voting at your polling place.
News 8's Matt Barcaro has that information.
Election day for the primary is almost here, but are you ready for it? Do you know where to go to vote? So here's what to check. You can go to the state's website, vote.pa.gov. There you can go to a feature called Where's My Polling Place? You fill out your address and it'll tell you where to go to vote on election day. This is a good thing to check even if you've already voted, because sometimes polling places can change election to election. If you've moved since the last time you voted or you're a first-time voter, make sure you bring your ID with you. That could include a driver's license, a PennDOT ID card, or a passport. You'll use that to check in at your polling place before you vote. If you voted at the place where you voted before, you will not need your ID. So, when can you vote? Polls open across the state at 7 on the morning of April 23rd. They close at 8 that night. If you're in line to vote at 8 o'clock, you are allowed to stay in line until you vote. With your voter guide, Matt Barcaro, WGAL News 8.
Still to come, we're taking a look at some of the most contested races on the ballot in this primary.